Well, it's time for Great Day Food. How about, I want to see this, an easy meal for a weeknight dinner.
We need easy and yummy. Chef Plum is joining us, and he's showing us how to make cacio e pepe. Am I saying that right?
It works for me. Listen, I grew up down south, so I butcher any Italian word I attempt to say. Trust me, I get yelled at all the time for it. I mean, I say cacio e pepe, but, you know.
Okay,
that wasn't bad, was it, Joe? That was all right.
Our producer, Jamie, is Italian. I think I said it right, right, Jamie? Yep. And it's cheese and pepper?
Yep.
Yes.
Exactly.
I got the thumbs up.
Okay. Exactly. And if I said it wrong there too, she would have just cut my feet immediately. Trust me, she would have nothing to do with that. Cacio e pepe, one of my favorite dishes. Listen, this is that time of year right now, especially around my house where, you know, you've got one girl's got Girl Scouts, someone's got dance, we've got horseback riding. And before you know it, it's, you know, 7 o'clock at night and we got to feed the kids still. So this is a great weeknight meal, but I want to show you a couple different takes on a traditional cacio e pepe. Now, cacio e pepe, think about that. Cheese and pepper. That's really all it is. So let me show you how it's done. I'm going to get my special high-tech equipment out here, which is just my little special burner. And I've got my pasta already ready to rock and roll. But I want to show you one thing that people probably don't know or understand. When you're making pasta, fill your pot with water and put enough salt in there to where it tastes like the ocean. Right? You want a lot of salt in that pasta water because that's where it gets all that flavor from. There's no seasoning on that. And it really absorbs that and gives it tons and tons of flavor. And it's the difference between a great pasta dish and a not great pasta dish. And it's simple. Just season the pasta. That easy.
Okay,
so let me show you what I've got so far.
Let me ask you a question. Does the salt go in before it boils or after, or it doesn't matter?
I put it in my cold water, right, when I'm starting my pasta. Okay. I always start with cold water and bring it to a boil with that salt in there. So what we've got here is I've got my salt, my pasta here. So I'm going to take some of this pasta and that water, get it nice and mixed around and ready to go. And what we do is I take this is a traditional cacio e pepe. I'm going to put that cheese, Parmesan cheese shredded right in the pan, just like this. And then we need the pepe part. So I'm going to put a little bit of that black pepper right in there, just like this. This black pepper adds so much flavor to this. And then what I do is I start ladling in putting my pasta in there. And then you want that water, right? You want some of that water. That's okay. That's where you get that flavor from. And I even will take a little ladle here and ladle in some of that pasta water. Because that pasta water has that extra starch in there from the pasta, right? So then we get a little mix around and it gets that nice, delicious, creamy texture. Let me show you. I'm going to add a little more water to it. Just start to give a little mix around here. And that cheese starts to melt down in that water and make the most unbelievable sauce, creamy, delicious sauce, done with the pepper, done with the cheese. It gets so yummy, so delicious. And there's a couple different things we can do with this. I'm gonna show you some different takes on it. So then I take this and you can see how that sauce starts to really melt down in there. Can you guys get a shot of that? I think you can kind of see how it's starting to melt down in there. Melts down, becomes creamy, delicious, unbelievable. Let me get this on the plate and get this out the way here. And let me show you how I'm gonna make it a little bit different now. So we're gonna do the exact same thing here, okay? I'm going to rinse off my pan so it's not so messy. And I'm going to add a little bit of cheese to it. I'm going to add that pepper to it. I'm going to add a little bit of this warm water to it, just like this. Start getting that mix around nice. And then what I've got is some delicious raviolis, right? So we can switch up the pasta a little bit. Very, very simple. Just add those raviolis to it, just like this. And we're going to toss that around. And then now, instead of just having that pasta, we've got these delicious raviolis. You could do the meat ravioli, you can do the cheese ravioli, whatever you want to do. There's no right or wrong here. So you take these guys and just put them down on the plate with that delicious pasta, that delicious sauce, right like that. Put some of that extra cheese on there. Unbelievable. I think that's amazing. I'll finish off a little sage leaf, a little extra cheese on top. Tasty. Now, I've got one more for you. One more different version of this that's kind of my take on it. I've got my pan here with some bacon, right? So I cooked off a little bit of bacon, and I've got that bacon fat still in the bottom of the pan here. And listen, Joe, I know that bacon fat's something you like a lot too, as much as I do.
So nice and crispy too, yum, yum.
Oh, yeah. So we're going to let that get nice and warm, and all I'm going to do is add that cheese to that bacon fat, add that black pepper to that bacon fat, let it start to melt down some, mix in next. There's so much flavor in that. That's exactly what you're talking about. You want all that flavor. Now I'm going to add a little bit of this water. Now, don't let that bacon fat get too hot because putting water and bacon fat together are not best friends. But just a little bit in there, adding that bacon fat, mix it up with your tongs or your spoon or whatever you're using there. Now, I like to use, I get asked this a lot, I like to use shredded Parmesan like this. I shred it up because I like to have little strings of Parmesan in my pasta when I'm doing it. Yeah. You know, a lot of people use just the grated one. And when you grate it, it kind of dissipates into the sauce. But I like those little strings of cheese in there. So I'm going to add a little bit of our pasta to it, just like this, right in there. And I'm taking that pasta, just warm pasta, right out of that water. Look at this. Let me move this super expensive cooking contraption. It's not expensive. It's a camping stove, but it works great for doing this right on the countertop. So I take this guy here, just put this around your plate, add that sauce. That sauce is going to turn a little bit brown because of the bacon fat, but that's delicious. And I'm going to top it with some of this bacon, just crumble that right on top of there. Come on, are you kidding me? This is delicious. And listen, this takes no time. The longest part of this is cooking the pasta. That's all it is. You want to liven it up a little bit, throw a little tomato on there. And if you want to get really crazy, you can take a little shred of lemon off your zester just to brighten it up, just like that. This is an easy, easy meal you can make on a weeknight, incredibly simple and very, very fast. When you forget, you know, like me, when you're driving to Girl Scouts, you're driving to dance, you're driving to horseback riding. I lose track of where I'm driving. I didn't know that when I became an adult, I was going to be an Uber service. Me and my wife did the same thing.
Yes. We become Ubers and chefs. At least you were already one.
Right, that's right. Well, listen, hey, also don't forget this week's season on WNPR. We have a great show. We're talking all about cider in the fall. I got to go to an amazing cider mill. Let me tell you something. I learned a lot. Uh-oh. Did you guys know that cider itself was always alcoholic? Hard cider is redundant. It's like saying TV and television in the same sentence. Right.
Really? I didn't know that.
I just keep thinking about all the bacon fat I've wasted tossing it into a can and bringing it. You just save it and use
Apparently
it.
Apparently you can use it and make it a good sauce. All right.
Oh, yeah, absolutely. There you go. Just like that.
All righty. Thank you, Chef Plum. Yummy, yummy.
Have a great day. Take care,
Thanks
friends.
Thanks for that.
And if you want to watch that again, go to our website, greatdayct.com.